Good evening, ma'am.
Yeah, good evening.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Sanjeevani Atram. Topic assigned to our group is a study on organization culture and its impact on employees' behavior in Tata Consultancy Service under the guidance of Dr. Reena Lenka, ma'am. To know its impact on employees' behavior, we must understand some basic concepts of organization culture. So let's start with its definition. Next slide. Organization culture is basically a system of shared assumptions, values, and beliefs which governs how people behave in organization. It acts as a social bond. It is quite complex. Every company has its own unique personality, just like people do. In fact, every religion, caste, or country has its own culture through which it is identified. Similarly, the unique personality of an organization is referred to as its culture. Culture unites means bring together the employees by providing a sense of identity with the organization, like decision making or the attitudes. It also includes an organization expectations, experiences, and values that hold it together and is expressed in the form of its self-image, inner workings, interaction with the society, and future expectation. It is also based on written and unwritten rules that have been developed over time and are considered valid. For example, if you see, would you dress the same way to attend a golf tournament as you would attend a football game? Absolutely not. Although both are sporting events, but there are some unwritten rules. That dictate what is the considered way to acceptable way to dress for each event. And the people in attendance will tell you whether you have dressed appropriately or not. These shared values have a strong influence on people in the organization and dictate how they dress, act, and perform their jobs. This is all about organization culture. Next slide will be explained by my colleague.
Yeah, who is next?
Vaibhavi, you there?
Who is next, guys?
Am I audible?
Yeah. Continue.
My name is Vaibhavi Ghodke. I'll be introducing about the company. So Tata Consultancy Services. Tata Consultancy Services is an Indian multinational information technology service.
I guess some network issues are there. Vaibhavi, are you facing some network issue?
I think she is facing some technical issues.
Okay, no problem. You can go to the next slide. Whoever is next.
Ma'am, am I audible?
Yeah, you are.
I can continue now.
You can continue? Okay, good. Yeah. Go ahead.
My name is Vaibhavi Ghodke. I'll be introducing about the company, Tata Consultancy Services. Tata Consultancy Services is an Indian multinational information technology services and consulting company. Its headquarters is in Mumbai, which is situated in
PhD qualified experts from different computing domains.
The sector throughout the globe of over $169.2 billion. It is a subsidiary of Tata Group and of 39 locations across 36 countries. From the year 1960, Natarajan Chandrasekharan is the chairman of Board of Assam, holding company of the Tata Consultancy Services. Indian industrialist and former chairperson of Tata Sons, Mr. Tata said, "I come."
What I feel, she is facing some network issues. You take over next one, please. Take over the next line, please.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Okay.
So let me start by introducing my name. My name is Anjali Kothari. I will be illustrating about the objectives of our topic. So till this point of time, we all know what is organizational culture and introduction to TCS. So let's begin with the objectives of our study. The purpose of this study is to understand the nature of the specific business organization, background of the TCS, its brief history services offered by the company, and its organizational structure and competition. First, to foster an environment of understanding the employees better. Second, to create a positive organization culture on employees. So nowadays in many organizations, the managers have indicated that in today's highly competitive environment, knowledge management is the best, is the key to organizational success. So for that, it's necessary to understand the difficulties and the problems being faced by the employees and help to solve them by inculcating new ideas, which will help create a positive and a better organizational culture environment, and so as to achieve the organizational goals. Third, to study the impact of organizational culture on employees' behavior in TCS. Fourth, to identify the factors affecting employees' behavior in TCS based on accumulative literature review and secondary data. So this is very common in every company that most of the times decision takers are biased. So this shouldn't be happened. There should be a formal reporting relationship within an organization, including the numbers or including the number of levels in the hierarchy and the span of control of managers and supervisors. Also, there shouldn't be grouping of individuals into departments and all. And the other further studies have been taken into consideration and been displayed in literature review and secondary data. Fifth, to determine how to improve the existing organizational culture and future growth in TCS. So as TCS has always been aware of innovative ways to be a customer center, so they can take this strategy into consideration for their future operations. This will help them maintain efficient relations with them and motivate the employees to take right decisions. Now, next, I would like to take over by my colleague, literature review.
Hello. Yeah, I'm Kaushal Yadav, and I would like to take you through the literature review. Organizational culture is now a prevalent topic amongst managers, consultants, and academics. As a means of distinguishing the member of one group from another, enterprise culture gives identities to organizations, groups, and individuals. There is no such single definition for organizational culture, but for several instances, different views have been shared. For example, Grade in 2010 states that the process of thinking helps in establishing one member from another on the basis of cognitive thinking. On the other hand, Sychin in 2004 defines organization culture as the success guidance based upon different values and norms that make culture effective. Kotler in 1992 stated the set of beliefs, behaviors, norms, and values helps in making culture most effective. Even if there is no single definition for the concept of organizational culture, and even if cultures are very different from one another, formalities do exist. Hofstede in 2010 introduced an onion model to cover the total concept. The figure shows the same. The figure consists of symbols. Symbols include words, pictures, architecture, service model, or any other object that carry a particular meaning. Heroes are persons who carry characteristics that are highly recognized, and they serve as role model for showing the correct values. Rituals include social behavior, discourse, and way of the language is used. For example, respect. Within culture, rituals are considered socially essential. The core of culture is accordingly formed by values. Values mainly refer to fundamental beliefs, ethics, and spirit of an organization. Robbins, in 2010, outlined 7 primary characteristics that capture the essence of an organizational culture, which are innovation and risk-taking. Employees are encouraged to be creative, take risks, which produce creativity. Innovation is an also form of productivity. Attention to detail. Employees are expected to be attentive. Details always determine success or failure. Outcome orientation. Management focuses on final outcomes or the processes used to achieve those goals. People orientation. The consideration in management decisions tend to affect people within the organization. Team orientation. A work event is organized amongst teams or individuals. Aggressiveness. A person is aggressive or competitive or easygoing during work. Stability. Organization is looking forward to maintaining the status quo or keeps going. Nowadays, organizational culture has generally been associated with management. There are 2 main essential factors that have influenced our effective cultural management: structural stability and integration of superior standard of organizational culture. Thank you. That's all from my side. Now I would like my friend Malik to take over.
Hello, my name is Malik Shan, role number 123. Today I'm going to discuss research and methodology. If we see TCS as it's an MNC, and let's understand why TCS requires research. So as we see, research technology is disturbing the environment, but also, you know, it's a kind of technology breakthroughs. All this can be achieved through extensive research efforts and collaborative innovation. Research will play an important role when it comes to the information technology industry. As we see that technology is transferring our life, how we interact, even how we use the softwares on a daily basis. So as technology becomes complex day by day, TCS will come with different solutions and that can solve their employees as well as outdoor solutions. So if we see from the other perspective, TCS research believes in invention and innovation. So before applying any research, they need to understand, and they're trying to understand why we require this research and what is the intention behind of it. So once that research is going to implement for the organization, so this research, the result or the outcome should make the organization a smarter, better, safer, as well as more sustainable place, and keeping all the departments in mind. So if you see from the other hand, as I mentioned that before applying any research, they do the market analysis, the indoor and outdoor, why we need to do this research. And this research will cover behavior and social sciences, computing system, embedded system and robotics, deep learning, life sciences, and more, and many more, enabling companies to ride each wave of digital transformation successfully. So as per the research, currently TCS has over 100 PhD qualified experts. You know, they go to deep analysis of any research before they are going to apply. And if we see from the other hand, TCS is it has a very diverse culture. So the employees are not specifically from one department or from one region. So if they are going to come with some research or new ideas, they need to consider all the departments as well as their nationalities, their races, and their, you know, employee types. Because if they're going to implement, it should not happen that it is going to be beneficial for the finance, but it's not going to be beneficial for the HR. So they need to consider both personal and professional lives. And yeah, so in addition to that, they're going to consider the outdoor as well, that how it can be beneficial to the society as well by doing this research. Now I would like to pass on to my colleague.
Thank you, Malik. Good evening, ma'am. I'm Sandeep Damkonwar from number 118. I will be discussing about the methods of data collection. So as we know, the data collection is the most crucial process in the research. and it is a crux of any research. Basically, there are two kinds of data collection. First one is primary and other one is secondary. In primary, so first we will see the primary data collection, how we collected the data from in primary section. The primary data collection is a fresh data, I mean first-hand data, in which original data, original characteristics, and we form the forms to collect the data in primary data collection. So what are the sources of gathering the primary data? We need to observation and sources of gathering data, and other one is questionnaire. So for gathering the questionnaire, we create the Google form and we gather server response from there, and we take the response from TCS employees to gather their views on the questions and what types of question were there, and there was response are different. On that different responses, we carried out research, and in secondary data, the data we collected by someone else, and we use the data for our research. There are two types of data, secondary data collection. Okay, first one is internal and second one is external. Let's talk about internal data collection. We have some internal information provided by some of the TCS employees after interaction with them and by visiting the TCS websites. And external data collection, we got some data from research papers and previous research papers and various books and newspaper articles and written by someone else and Google search engine and various other reports. The main sources we collected the data from both primary and secondary. Also, we collected data from Google research websites and questionnaire. That's it from our side. Over to you, Satya. Thank you.
Thank you, Sandeep. My name is Satyam.
And my name is Yogesh Vadche.
We both are going to explain about the data analysis and interpretation. So first of all, I would like to inform you that we did a Google form survey and we got 14 responses from the TCS employees, from which 5 employees are freshers, 8 employees have 1 to 5 year experience, and one of the employee having 5 to 10 year experience. So now we head over to our questionnaire section. Okay, so our first question is employee afraid to express disagreement with their managers frequently? So from the response we got of 14 TCS employees, 50% of the employees are not afraid, whereas 28.6% employees are sometime afraid, and remaining 21.4 employees are afraid to express disagreement with the manager frequently. So according to the data, we can conclude that freshers are afraid to put their point forward. The second question is, the environment in the organization support a balance between work and personal life. From the above pie chart of 14 responses of people, as 85.7% of the employees strongly agree that the environment in the organization support a balance between work and personal life, and only 14.3% of the employees disagree. So from this we can infer that there is a friendly environment at the firm. Next slide. Okay, so our third question is, how is your work experience at TCS? So from the above pie chart of 14 responses from TCS employees, 78.6% of the employee had a good work experience, whereas 21.4% employees had an excellent work experience at the TCS. The fourth question is, how is communication between subordinates and superior during work hours? So from collected data, we can see that 78.6% of the employee have formal communication, and 14.3% of the employees have informal communication, and remaining 7.1% have both an formal and informal communication between their subordinate and superior during work hours. Over to you, Yogesh.
So the next question is, do you think the work is distributed evenly across your team? From the above pie chart of 14 responses, 71% of the employees agree Another 14% do not agree about even work distribution across the team. And we can infer that as the majority of the employees agree the work is evenly distributed at the TCS. Next question. Does company offers adequate opportunities for promotions and career development? From the pie chart of 14 responses, all the employees, 100% employees agree TCS makes a substantial investment in employee engagement with fitness and well-being. The two key areas that TCS has engaged and motivated employees altogether. Next slide. Do manager values your feedback? From the pie chart of 14 responses by the employees, majority of the employees said that manager values their feedback. This shows that the company values the employees' opinions. How happy are you at your workplace? From the bar chart of 14 responses of the people, 71.4% of the employees said that they are happy with the ratings of 4 at their workplace. Another 14% of the employees has rated 3 for happiness at workplace, and remaining 14% are very happy at their workplace with the ratings of 5. Now I will hand over to my colleague.
Yes, who's next?
Yes, hello ma'am.
Yeah, hi.
So here's the discussion. The discussion session, as we discussed, the aim of the study was to find out how organizational culture affects employees' behavior. The reliability of the study is measured with the help of the Google form, which is filled by number of employees. Google form, which is filled by number of employees, and observation conducted in the case company. The case company is one of the oldest firm in India with a strong organizational culture. Because of the current situation of COVID-19 pandemic, we couldn't able to take the interview of the employees directly, but in the addition, the researchers observed employees' behavior directly without any influence on it. All the data was analyzed carefully, therefore the study is reliable. In this study, the data were collected by the Google form and observation. As discussed by Satyam and Sandeep, the various questions asked to the employees. The limitation is that the question asked in the Google form did not cover all sides of the organizational culture, and there was not much more time for further questions. The data might not be collected completely and may lead to ambiguity. In addition, observations are subjective, and it is difficult to compare the outcome from different people. The studies correlated with the cultures that have influenced on people's behavior. With the culture that have influenced on people's behavior within an organization could be further investigated. Moreover, further studies could also take other factors into account, such as personalities and ethnic culture. Slide change now. Change the slide. So here's the result. As you can see, when it comes to define the organizational culture, the organization culture is defined as an underlying belief, assumption, values, and ways of interacting that contribute to the unique social and psychological environment of an organization. From the data collected and the above discussion, we can see that organizational culture is the basic pattern of shared assumptions, values, and beliefs that govern behavior within a particular organization. Throughout the discussion, it was evident that organizational culture is pervasive and powerful. For corporate leaders, it is either a force for change or an insurmountable barrier to it. For employee, it is either that glue that bound to people together or the force that drives them away from the organization. Apart from that, organizational culture also includes an organization expectation, experiences, philosophy as well as the value that guide member behavior and is expressed in the member's self-image, inner working, interaction with the outside world and future expectation. Moving ahead, from the collected data, we can see, however, the case study found that not every behavior was affected by the organizational culture. Still, some part of employees' behavior has a strong correlation with the culture. According to our observation, organizational culture is not stagnant. Members of an organization develop a shared belief around what rights look like as they interact over time and learn how what yields success and what doesn't. In short, culture is a set of values and beliefs for which individuals are equipped with cultures, tools to understand, interpret and utilize the culture symbols that are presented within the everyday world. As from the above discussion, I can say that an absolute definition would allow not only for more rigorous study of organizational culture, but also increase our understanding of how it influences other organizational outcomes, such as productivity, employees, engagement, and commitment. One thing is undoubtedly known about culture. It is constantly being created, changed, and splintered to ensure the success of its parent organization. That's it for the result. I would like to moving ahead, the limitation section will be discussed by the Atharva.
Hello everyone, my name is Paresh Bhagwan, roll number 117. I would like to give suggestions and recommendations for Tata Consultancy Services. First, I would like to explain something about Tata Consultancy Services. TCS is the second largest Indian company by market capitalization. Tata Consultancy Services is now placed among the most valuable IT services brands worldwide. In 2015, TCS was ranked 64th overall in the Forbes World's Most Innovative Companies ranking, making it both the highest ranked IT services company and the top Indian company. Besides listing in the top companies, I would like to share some suggestions and recommendations. The purpose of this study is to understand the impact on employees' behavior in Tata Consultancy Services about how different various employees have their different views and perspectives in working in this business organization. The study behind the employees' behavior is important for identifying thoughts and views for enhancing and developing in the management, which the employees think that they should provide more training options and have experience sharing sessions among employees. The management may enhance the frequency of employees' feedback's performance, which means the employees which are working in the company, the management may increase their paycheck depending on the performance. In training programs, practical sessions must receive greater emphasis, which is basically the employees should receive greater emphasis in training program. The management should listen to their problems during sessions or any problem of the employee is going through. I would like to hand over to my fellow panelists.
Hello, ma'am. My name is Kausar Naikar. I am audible, ma'am?
Yeah, you are audible. You are audible. Go ahead.
Okay, ma'am. Some recommendations for TCS. TCS should look closely towards their competitors who are rich in the experience and finance builder strategy to define in future expansion plans for competition. If TCS wants to earn more profit, then TCS need to maintain their focus on its core services and also expanding itself into related chains of services like introduction and international airline services will give TCS new streams of profit. For getting foreign exchange in country, TCS should try expanding and grabbing more international market share, which has started to harvest its land for the business cultivation. It is necessary for TCS to organize training programs for employees because it should be further oriented and objectives in nature. Now I would like to hand over to my colleagues. Next slide.
Thank you, Parvez and Kaustubh. I am Atharva Gadbole, roll number 119. While collecting data for research, we have come across some limitations and we also thought that there is a scope for future research also. First, let's talk about the limitations. As we have limited time for collecting data, we kept the area for the research limited to Pune. Because of this, we all can see the sample data is very small compared to the number of the TCS employees. And the pandemic situation also becomes the reason, one of the limitations for the research. After talking about limitations, let's have a look at the scope for the future research. As we can see, the research is done only for Pune, so it can be done at different level, such as country or continent, because TCS is in the MNC working across borders. The research can be done in different frameworks. The research can be done in different settings, contexts, and locations. As we have discussed, TCS works at different locations. Talking about the settings, then we can say that detailed research can be done. The research can apply different strategy. The researchers can apply different strategy for research. As we seen in the data analysis and research methodology, the data collected through questionnaire, the researcher can use different data collection strategies. After all this, one of the most important scope for the research is for the company itself. With the help of the research and data, the researcher can design the HR or the management can design their policies accordingly. And with this, they can improve their office environment. That's from my side. Now I would like to hand over to my colleague.
Hello, everyone. Hello, ma'am.
Yeah.
According to this research for the above project, we can conclude.
Okay, that just hold on. Just hold on. Okay, since we are running short of time, since you are just telling the conclusions, it's okay. I'll just ask you one thing. What's your name? You said.
Okay. My name is Sai.
Okay, Sai. Okay. So, according to you, what is lacking in TCS in terms of organization culture? Anything lacking?
What is lacking? They should encourage the freshers.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. As they have very transparent value drive corporate governance.
Mm-hmm.
They are also ranked number one in Data Quest. So there's only one lack in the company.
Mm-hmm.
As they work as a family, so there are not any disadvantages.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Okay, and how organization culture is important for any organization? So, how it can benefit the organization? Anyone else wants to answer this question? Because we have been talking about the benefits and all those stuff, you have explained organization culture. So, my question is, how organization culture would be beneficial for an organization?
Yes, ma'am. My name is Satyam. I can explain this.
Yeah. Go ahead, Satyam.
As organizational culture helps us to build mutual relationships between the employees and managers.
Mm-hmm.
So it also helps to promote the work devotion and the feeling of between the colleagues and employees. They will work together and better for the betterment of the organization. So it will be benefited directly.
Right. So, Malik, yes.
Can I provide answer to your first questions? I have some.
Sure.
What I believe, these big companies, especially TCS or Wipro and all these companies, they need to work on the politics. Because there is too much politics in these companies, if there is a low level, middle level and top level, they cannot communicate properly.
Correct.
If they can communicate, then this communications will be diverted in a different ways. So
correct.
They need to work on the politics as well as this communications level. That is my opinion.
Yeah. No, you are absolutely right. Nowadays, organizational culture, we are talking about people, we are talking about everything, but sometimes we forget about the emotions of the people. Right.
Exactly.
And then that politics and everything comes, and we actually don't care what a person is thinking, right? We don't actually care about the feeling of a person. So when we are talking about organization culture, we should be also taking into consideration regarding the feeling of the people, how well we can maintain a good relation. If you're maintaining a good relation, then what happens is that people start respecting each other and people start working better, right? And the atmosphere become a very positive one. So you are absolutely right, Malik. I agree to that. So that is your recommendation, but a very good recommendation. So anyways, this is the end of the presentation and my asking questions. And, you know, congratulations, all of you have done a wonderful job. And one thing was there, like when I gave this project and all these things, I wasn't expecting that you people would be going into so much trouble into getting into so much details and all those stuff. But I'm really happy that you people have really worked. And I can see 120 students, 123 students, they've really become good researchers, which is actually good for Naval Vadia, right? And it's good. I really enjoyed all these things, whatever you people have given me the input. And I've learned myself also so many things. So anyways, thank you so much. And good luck to you all. And God bless you. Yeah. So take
care.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay.
Thank you, ma'am.
Bye.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah.